this is the first meeting, the first workshop about these topics. 2 years ago, I won a research project in Art Cities Tourism and with the shopping experience topic. So after the COVID, we decided to improve our area of research and to go to the urban studies and to new approaches of the urban studies. My speech is an introduction, very, very short, Giacomo, because yesterday changed. I'm joking. So thank you all for coming, for international professors. I know that it's very difficult to come to Rome because it's a bad city, and the time is not good, the city is, I don't know, it's, there is a lot of waste. It's a sacrifice, I think, you're coming Rome for you. Is it true?
She wanted to make a joke, but I'm not sure if you got
that. I thought, yes, it's true.
No, it's not true.
No. So thank you for coming to Rome. I have three questions. The first one, how, and three considerations. The first one is how urban studies matters on tourism studies, urban tourism studies matters on our research area. The second is how cities are so relevant. And the third is what means to investigate the art city and historical art cities. This is these are my three questions, and I try to go to the presentation. Okay. So the first answer is because the urbanization is a continuing process from the middle of 18th century. I have some information, okay. And today too, the urbanization, maybe Barbara Pizzo, Professor Pizzo can told us, is a continuum process. The COVID doesn't stop this process. And the forecasts are that for the 2050, we will be 70, we will have 70% of population approximately 10 billion, so we live, 7 billion, so we live in the cities. So it is a very big area, a very big field of studies, and it's an important social and economic factor for human development. And I synthesize very in a very shortly way what we consider when we talk about the shifting from functionality to complexity. Because the city and the urban assets in the last two centuries, the urban asset will be an asset for functional activities. Functional means that we have a specialization, for example, for transportation, for accommodation, for infrastructure and similar and so on. Today, we will live in a complexity cities, and maybe it's clear on the tourist studies because we talk about a different level of experiences, for example, for tourists in the cities. We talk about the local and tourist relationship and the over tourism too, we will see. So today we have a new way that we can consider. This is the polycentric cities. It's not simple to say in English. Maybe if it's so difficult for me, I'll translate, I'll go to Italian. What is the polycentric cities? A definition, if, a new definition from an architect, Boeri. Who say that today the cities, some cities are so big that we need to consider a city of an aggregate, an agglomeration of small cities. So where we talk about archipelagos, and now maybe you see that it's very famous to talk about 15 minutes services and activities in the city. So this is a big change because we move from a functional city to a complex cities with a different level to a polycentric city. So we will have a lot of cities inside the city. Maybe in the marketing terms, Kotler defined this approach as a shift from one market to a mass market. So we are shifting from a city to a mass of cities. This is the concept that very synthesized of the polytechnic cities. So we have some picture. Some consideration about the urban tourism. The second question, how the urban tourism is matter. Sometimes people study tourism trying to demonstrate that urban tourism and tourism in urban cities can create an high economic value. But the reality is that the tourism is matter, but for the cities, it is not the most important economic activity. Could be an important activity, but never is the uniqueness and principal economic activity, because the cities has a different and multidimensional activities. So for the urban tourist perspective, this is a very synthetic consideration. The urban tourism is a huge area of investigation, but there is something maybe to remark. It's not easy to define not urban tourism. Maybe all of us understand what we mean when we talk about urban tourism. But for a long time, urban tourism defined a kind of tourism realized in a city, the spatial dimension, not the specific behavior of the tourist. This is, for example, before the 2000s. The studies before the 2000s are very poor. And after the 2000, we are the studies grow, and the big part of the studies are from 2015-2019. For example, yeah, maybe some brief evidences about the studies in urban tourism. For example, only some journals consider the urban studies as a field of research. Maybe there is a shift from the specialized urban studies, for example, Journal of Cities to City Tourism, to tourism studies. In the last 10 years, we have had some papers published by tourist management, tourist geographies, international tourism, International Journal of Tourist Cities, because it's clear that the urban studies and tourism studies, tourism urban studies, are a multidisciplinary field. While there were various studies in the urban tourism field, most studies were in the social science field. It seems that urban studies and architectural studies, for example, or social studies, not necessarily talk and integrate their studies with us, and we don't integrate our studies with that. The studies were related to a sustainable tourism in the last decades, and sustainability. Do the welcome tourism above the capacity of the cities? For example, the carrying capacity is one of the indicators most considered, but 3 years ago, European Union realized a report that on that said, we need to redefine the indicators about tourism, not necessarily only on the city, but also only on the city, because maybe carrying capacity is not enough to understand the impact, the spillover effect of the tourism in the city. The prevalent words on the publication of urban tourism are experiences, effects, satisfaction, attitude, perception, and management. And the high centricity in a bibliometric literature review, we can find the high centricity of the two publications, Ashworth and Page and Jude. The last. The use of the city by the tourists, as I mentioned, is never an exclusive use, but the studies on the relationship between locals and tourists in the city become the studies of over-tourism, prevalently over-tourism. Not necessary is over-tourism. Over-tourism is one of the bad phenomenon But also the new definition of the city as a spatial and the humanization of the city as a spatial relations between people needs another approach to study to understand the tourist behavior in the city and also the tourist choice process. Multifunctionality contributes to make a city attractive. There are a lot of identity, for example, and atmosphere are well known and extensively studied in literature, as well as the urban, historical, and social context. So the radical changes ask to us to consider new approaches to urban studies and to perspective, the perspective of tourism in the urban studies. For example, some consideration. For example, one of the main difference that we can see that is the attraction of the city is represented by the dynamization of the city offer. We can consider, for example, culture, this is the main topic, shopping, entertainment, events, and similar. We can see, and this is the definition of 2019 of the United Nations World Tourism Organization, we can see some city world city tourism. These cities are big cities. For example, the 10 of the most tourist cities, touristic cities, attract more than 200 million international arrivals. I have a chart. For example, these are the. This is an Eurostat font, source. It's a European officially source. We can see each square here represent one city. We can see which kind of international cities are more attractive: Asia, Europe, Americas, and Middle East. And we can see the top 10. Attractive cities. Hong Kong, for example, the second is Bangkok, and so on. It is important to see, for example, the different amount of arrivals they have. Hong Kong has more than 29 million arrivals. Sometimes a city has more international arrivals than a country, for example, more than Tunisia. So these kind of cities are destination, and the development of the tourism in this kind of city is peer-to-peer, point-to-point. A city, an international world city, it isn't able to transfer, to create a value in the area. For example, Rome, it isn't able to create value and to share this value for the Lazio region. So, this is one, it's very simplified. This is one of the aspects we can consider when we talk about world tourist cities. But what means to talk about urban tourism and city tourism? Because sometimes that could be different terms we need to define before. But what means when we talk about city tourism and the international tourism attraction that the city has. It is important to consider, and finish, is it important to consider one thing? If the hypothesis is that the world international city tourism become attractive because they are dynamic, they are capable to offer a different kind of experiences to tourists, what means about art cities? Because art cities, I go back, art cities are considered immutable. They are considered fixed. They are attractive, derived by their uniqueness. But most of art cities are UNESCO heritage. You can transform anything. So what means in terms of tourism? It means that the tourists has a low length of stay, for example. They haven't a repetitive come to these cities. It means that there is a different approach to art cities. You know, it's not easy to define art cities. I tried to find a lot of definition, but isn't a one definition in the literature and also in the practice. For example, we have a definition, maybe, okay, this is the definition of our government. They say in their website, we are trying to define, but this is the definition, it's a commonly used definition. Well, we can consider art and historical city, the cities that have an important historical center, for example, UNESCO recognized center. It not depends on the dimension of the city. So it seems that the big cities are similar to medium and small cities. My last consideration is, this is, what do you mean? It is. It would be an important topic because we have a problem. Rome is, if you investigate the awareness of Rome, Rome is in the third place of the world. If you see the arrivals of Rome, we are 16. Maybe there is Paris before, is sixth place. So what means to come to Rome? The shift between 3S, sand, sea, and sun to 3E, entertainment, education, I don't remember the test, sorry. and excitement, what means for this kind of city? So we thought that it would be interesting to investigate the phenomenon and the tourism in the art city. And I close with a consideration because we done a research 3 years ago, for example, for shopping activities. And we saw that the environment of the city, the atmosphere, the authenticity of the historical center represent an important component, an important dimension of the experience of dissatisfaction. For example, all tourist studies don't investigate this aspect because, for example, for shopping, we have only two dimensions, in-shop experience, out-shop experience, but out-of-shops is considered mall or shopping village. Never, I never find a paper that consider the environment, the historical. So I think we can have a lot of work to do together if you want. And this is an introduction. So I can say that all the speeches today can add value to this consideration. For example, we need to talk about technology and old people, because old people lives also in the city. We must go, we need to talk of the experience and the retail and the shopping also to the airport. The airports are no place. Usually the sociologists define the airports as no place. And we need obviously of the urbanistic approach and to see what means in this kind of way. And finally, so we can give the word to Mariella, we need to talk about the sociological approach, because we saw the social science represent the main field of research of urban tourism.
Thank you.